Today we will take a closer look at Swaziland. Swaziland is located far south in Africa. Their flag is basically an African yin and yang symbol, with some spears and leaves. The first settlers in Swaziland, the Nwan, came to Swaziland in the 1700s. Swaziland has four provinces, Shiselweni, Lubombo, Manzini, and Uluhuru. Swaziland is a monarchy. Their most important leader was Mswati II. He ruled in the 1840s. Swaziland was named after him. In the mid-1800s, Mswati asked the British for assistance against the Zulu raiders in Swaziland. The British totally kicked the Zulu raiders' butt. This was the first contact Swaziland had with the British. After Mswati's death, the British ruled Swaziland from 1906 to 1968. Swaziland is a member of the United Nations, the Commonwealth of Nations, and the African Union. Mswati III rules Swaziland today. He has 15 wives. He has too much swag for only one wife. Sadly, Swaziland is one of the poorest countries in the world. Half the population makes less than $1 per day, and almost 40% of the population has AIDS. The average life expectancy in Swaziland is 39.5 years. Some important natural resources are coal, hydropower, forests, and small amounts of gold and diamonds. But they also have weed.
Smoke weed every day.
Effects from weed, including but not limited to depression, suicidal ideation, suicide attempt, and completed suicide, have been reported in patients doing weed.
Still, even though Swaziland is one of the poorest countries in the world, and almost everyone has AIDS, Swaziland is the best damn country in the world. Just look at this. I hope you have enjoyed this documentary about Swaziland. Thank you for watching. Swaziland is also going to win World War III, making the entire world into a big Swazi world.
And everyone who is not Swazi will be killed.